nass. Da steht ein Soldat und hält wach. Träumt von Hans und dem Glück, das zu Hause blieb zurück.
Well, for a few months now, I've been searching for a period-correct sleeping bag, especially for my Gebirgsjäger impression, and I think I just found one that I'm satisfied with using for that impression. It's quite hard to find a German sleeping bag from World War II that is in usable condition and also that can fit my size. So with that in mind, I had to broaden my search just a little bit more and also look at different time period and country. And so I found this military sleeping bag from Belgium, this KL 1959. And there's no way that I'm going to pronounce this correctly. But yes, KL 1959 FRANS CHANTERIE SCHAUBROECK DEINZE. And I apologize for the pronunciation of this brand. This sleeping bag cover also came with a bag, and overall the sleeping bag and the sleeping cover seemed in very good shape. Of course, with items like this, there's always this storage smell. You know what smell I'm talking about, this old sleeping bag, old tent smell, and it was quite strong. Both for the bag and for the cover. The only damage that I can see is this small hole on the sleeping bag cover that has been fixed. But I'm really lucky with the condition on the sleeping bag itself and also the cover. Without knowing for sure, it feels like this is the filling or the insulation is most likely some kind of a cotton blend, maybe cotton or cotton wool blend. But that was quite common on these older sleeping bags. But the problem with this bag, if it gets wet, it will get quite heavy. And here at the bottom are the two straps where you can tie up the sleeping bag when you roll them up. The zipper is in good shape, but the problem with this kind of a large metal zipper is I'm thinking about if it gets extremely cold, it's going to conduct through the zipper to the body. And also if the zipper breaks, there are buttons on the inside of the folds that you can use to close up the sleeping bag. So when I put the cover over the sleeping bag, I noticed either this is not the right cover for this type of bag, or I haven't figured out the system to close the cover over the bag. Here you can see the rivet button. It's the same end of the button. So it's like plus and plus together and it doesn't fit. And also these rivet buttons on the hood on the bag cover do not seem to have any place on the sleeping bag itself. I found some photos of this type of sleeping bag and it seemed to be like a third cover with the hood inside the bag that corresponds with right buttons to fasten the cover over the sleeping bag. But please correct me if I'm wrong and put your thoughts on the comments below. A couple of solutions: either switch out these buttons, so find buttons that will fit the sleeping bag, or these buttons, they have holes in them, so if I just find a medium-sized cord that I can pull through these buttons and just lace it up to close up the cover. The size or the length of the sleeping bag is 185 centimeters. And about 80 centimeters wide, so it fits me well. Doesn't leave much room, but it's usable. And the cover is 2 meters and 15 centimeters, and it also, when I put the cover over the bag, the hood fits over my head. I am 197 centimeters, so both the bag and the cover fits me well. And now I'm glad to say I can switch out this modern sleeping bag with this vintage sleeping bag. Even though this modern sleeping bag is almost twice as lighter than the older one. The old one is 3.5 kilograms and the modern one is under 2 kilos. But I do not mind the extra weight, just to make my impression more period correct. I know this sleeping bag and the cover will add to the weight of the bag that I'll be carrying. So it depends how I'm gonna pack the bag, either if it's only a short trip that I don't need to take a lot of food and water with me. I can just stuff the bag, the sleeping bag, inside the rucksack. Or I can, if I'm carrying a lot of water, a lot of equipment, a lot of food, then I just roll it up and put it either on top of the bag or underneath the bag with the leather straps. And of course, same applies to all vintage rucksacks and backpacks. Last but not least, if you're thinking about getting a bag like this, you're gonna have to deal with the storage smell of these bags. Personally, I do not want to use any chemicals to spray inside or outside of the bag, so I just leave it out to hang in the elements. But just be careful to take it inside if it starts to rain. I will for sure make a quick review on how this bag comes out when I start to use it. But until then, thank you for watching and take care.